guys, welcome back to some more AFK Arena. Today we're over on the pay to win account and we're running through the stargazing priorities. So when it comes to the stargazing, there is a very specific way to build it. Every now and then we see updated guides, which we're gonna look at Zappy's guide in just a minute on how you should build this out. Getting your interpretation of it, I really think it is a very solid guide. It's exactly the priority on how most people build it. Now, you don't have to build it exactly to the priorities of the guide, but this really is the most beneficial way, especially if you are a free-to-play player, really following the guide to a T, and I will explain it and kind of break it down with my interpretation of it. So let's go ahead and we'll get into the guide. All right, guys, so here is our neon guide, and a big shout out to Zappy and Duck for the stargazing priorities. Very cool. The amount of time it takes to make these visuals, guys, that is the reason I really like to get the content out there and make sure you guys understand the priority to building the heroes to really help with the guides. A lot of players are not on Reddit. A lot of players are not on Discord. So I'm really hoping to get the information out there. So let's go ahead and we will break down Zappy's guide here. So looking on the top left, this is our beginning point. Getting the twins up to Elite Plus is a huge priority because nobody else does what they do. They are used in Twisted Realm bosses. We see them in a lot of the Trials of God, a lot of the campaign stages. Pretty much when it comes to a majority of AFK Arena, the twins are utilized. In addition, having them at Elite Plus allows them to enter the Abyssal Expedition, which is coming up very shortly, so they are the priority, at least having a couple copies of them to get in there, followed by Mortis. Mortis is the exact same thing. Within the Twisted Realm, he does make an appearance, so does the twins. He doesn't need signature item built. He doesn't need his furniture built, similar to early game twins. Ultimately, you just have to have them unlocked. And having him again at that Elite Plus allows you to use him with in the Abyssal Expedition, which is a really big priority when it comes to buffing the damage you're doing on bosses. Next one we see here is Elite Mahira. Big thing with Elite Mahira is regardless of how much you have her built, her Mesmerize ability will have the same effect. So she doesn't have to be up to Mythic. She doesn't have to have the signature items. She doesn't have the furniture. It does help. But ultimately, she doesn't require it, especially if you're early game. The Mesmerize effect will be super effective with her ultimate ability, and it will carry you for a lot of AFK Arena. Then we get into the priority, guys, the high priority of building out Lucretia. A lot of players ask, should I build Lucretia or should I build Ulna first? Absolutely build Lucretia. And the reason behind that is when you look at building Lucretia, she is a hero that can solo teams by herself. Ulna, while she is amazing support, she's the warrior class, she can provide survivability immunity to teams as well as a massive amount of debuffs. She still needs a team. Lucretia does not. Lucretia actually gets stronger as her team dies, which makes it a very interesting combination because she gets stronger when your heroes die. So again, that is the reason for Lucretia, because she does not need a team to really survive to push through the campaign stages. Ulna, of course, next. She, again, is a priority when it comes to the campaign. Just an absolute monster to kill with her immunity, with her Winter's Call ability, and able to debuff the haste of enemies makes her a huge priority. Again, because she has to be part of a team, she's built into teams, I would prioritize building Lucretia first, followed by Kazard. Kazard, guys, a lot of people really underestimate Kazard with his signature item, which is the reason why we are building him up to Mythic. With his signature item unlocked and at a plus 30 signature item, it increases the duration of all debuffs against the enemy by 60%. Just like the relic that we get within the Labyrinth, it increases the duration by 60%, meaning that Mahira's Mesmerize ability is going to be increased by 60%. As well as other heroes that have negative debuffs that they put onto the enemies, making Kazard very strong. Guys, he is a hero that is utilized for a majority of AFK Arena. He is kind of a glass cannon. You do have to protect him. But not only does he do the duration, a longer duration, but he also does provide multiple forms of crowd control, which makes him a very powerful hero to build when it comes to the Stargazer. Then, of course, now we have our Elite Mahira. Now we want to take her to Mythic. So as you're getting further into the campaign, as you're making more progression, there will come a point where Mahira needs to have her signature item. Not only the skills that it brings at the plus 10, 20, and 30, but also the stats that it brings as well makes a very big difference when it comes to the campaign as you're continuing to make progression to this point. Then look how far Taylene has fallen, guys. Taylene is a hero that used to be number one on the priority for wishlist forever. And now she is quite a ways down. And even here, it is only picking her up at elite. So just simply unlocking her, as you can see, it has a little heart rate next to her, which we'll talk about in just a minute. Next one on this list is Zafriel, guys. Zafriel provides an enormous amount of crowd control, especially when you have him built. He provides a lot of damage as well. If you've seen him utilized within the Celestial Towers, he does do a considerable amount of damage, which is why he is a higher priority to build when it comes to the summoning in the Stargazer. Followed by Zolrath. Zolrath has his little counter. You can see the little timer icon that Zappy put up here. Taking him up to Ascended, he's another hero that is very unique in what he does. Ultimately allowing you to win a lot of battles. If you do lose a battle, he resets the battle. And when he comes back from the reset, he is stronger, which is awesome. With the plus 30 signature item, you can ignore defense. He gets very strong very quickly. At this point, we take the twins up to Mythic, possibly up to Ascended is where you want to. Personally, my preference, I would take the twins to Mythic. They will perform very well at Mythic. Having that signature item up to a plus 20 signature item will make a difference when it comes to the campaign. Also, the survivability of the Twisted Realm. If they're dying out early in the Twisted Realm, I would go ahead and move them up to Ascended or even Mythic Plus to add that stat boost in there to increase their survivability within the Twisted Realm. Now, the next point is, of course, taking Lucretia up to one star. Big theory behind this is taking Lucretia up to one star is going to unlock the engraving system. So this is where you want to start moving all of your engraving mats into Lucretia to increase the power that she has to solo stages. Next, we look down here, we are into Mythic, and it is Mythic Mortis. Big thing, just like the twins, you'll start seeing the survivability issues when it comes to the Twisted Realm, and you'll actually see the heroes dying a lot faster than they need to, or he will be dying out a lot faster, not able to give out enough of his damage buff to really make a difference because he dies too quick. So taking him to Mythic, again, he really doesn't need his signature item built up too high to be effective. Then with progression, you start moving into your Ascended Mahiras. This is where we move Taylene to Ascended. Again, at this point, we would only have her at Elite. And there's a reason, which we're going to look at in just a minute. So taking her to Ascended, again, how far she has come down the list. Then moving here to Ascended Mortis, and then we get into the rest of the Celestial and the Hypogen lineup, followed with Kazard, Leofric. We have a Moriel in here, might be a little low on Moriel, but we have Mortis, and then we have Titus as well to finish out the Stargazing priority list. So a very solid list. You'll notice a couple heroes in here that we'll talk about in just a moment that are not present on the list, and there's a reason for it. So An elite copy helps early with the Dismal Lab stage with the lack of healers and is also essential for the Celestial Tower as the only healer in there, which is the reason to pick up the one elite copy as we've seen right up here, right here of Taylene. Now, same with Zolrath. Speeding up Zolrath's progression by gazing a few copies of him while also simultaneously picking him up from the Challenger store helps out a ton with progression in every game mode. He is essential to countering many Flora stages which appear as early as Chapter 35. We all know that the Flora stages in this game are an absolute nightmare, so anything that can make them easier, such as picking up Zolrath, will be beneficial. Now down here, we look at the Challenger store priorities. Here it is Merlin, so if you did not pick up Merlin just recently with the exchange, he is going to be the priority, followed by Zolrath. Again, speeding up the Zolrath cycle into getting him up to Ascended. Then it is Athalia. Aziz, down here a little bit. Ultimately with Aziz, he works similar to the other heroes. He doesn't have to be fully Ascended to really perform well. You can even just get him to Mythic, even a little bit lower as an energy battery. It will work well. But on the flip side, you have heroes like Athalia that do not work well because of the damage factor if she is not up to Ascended. So we have Aziz here. Then we have Orthos and Flora once you finally have all of the other four built. Flora and Wukong, we do get a lot of priorities. That is the reason we do not Stargaze for them. Looking in the Labyrinth, I love the new picture here of Arthur. Arthur, guys, is the biggest priority. Number one priority in the Labyrinth store is Arthur. Do not build the regular heroes. You can get them from Desired Summons, Faction Summons, all things of that nature. Get Arthur ASAP. Once you pick him up, guys, these Emblems of Space every single month, pick them up. Even if you're starting to get a lot of heroes with plus 30 signature items, continue to pick them up because there are more dimensionals that are coming down the line, especially if they do multiple dimensionals where they release one or two of them at a time. Build a stockade of those emblems. If you're starting to get too many Emblems of Space, start moving your heroes to higher than a plus 30 signature item for the dimensional heroes. And then, of course, Wukong. During the course of a month, you can usually buy Arthur Shards and Wukong or Emblems of Space and Wukong. If you find, again, an overflow of those, you can move to the red chest if you are buying all of these out that you can every single month. So guys, that will do it for the Stargazing priority. Again, big shout out to Zappy for the guide. I absolutely love the guides. There's not too many content creators left that create the guides of this magnitude and of this caliber. Absolutely love them, guys. So I will leave a link to the guide down below. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about the Stargazing priorities. And as always, thank you guys for watching.